solidarity forever.
So,
solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union makes us strong.
He is a little.
He is Africa.
Thank you very much. It was nothing other than the sense of duty that induced us to bring you here to discuss a matter that has festered and refused to heal. After almost 20 years of killings, maiming, disruption in our lives, arson, suspicion among neighbors, resettlements within our communities, heightening of religious and ethnic tension, it is time for us as a people to reflect and sheath our sword. It is time for reason. It is time for dialogue. It is time to be brave and sit around the table and talk.
How do we improve upon the cattle industry? It is doable. If only we can reflect on it. If only we can reason together. He says we should come and reason together. If only we can have that assurance or reassurance that we can work together. The two systems can work side by side.
When I addressed the Students' Union issue on this same matter, I said, I am as worried as you are, but there may be certain things you don't understand. I cannot pursue the line of confrontation on this matter. And I know why I need all the diplomacy to resolve this issue. I will be staying in my house. If there is a problem here, how can I protect it? I don't have the means. And that is why we need to be very, very cautious.
83% of all cultivable land in Katsina were already under cultivation. That's about almost 40 years ago. And in Kaduna, about 68% of all possible cultivable land were already under cultivation.
They didn't start today. They have always been there. As a small boy growing up, we used to have this kind of clashes. Normally you have cattle straight into farms, but the dynamics were not what we have at the moment. Over those days, you take the offending herdsman to either the community leader, the traditional ruler, or even in some cases, they are elders.